Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, in order to celebrate this sacred mysteries in a worthy manner, let's acknowledge our sins and pray. I confess,
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Attend to the pleas of your people with heavenly care, O Lord, we pray, that they may see what must be done, and gain strength to do what they have seen. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. The Holy Spirit says, "Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at the rebellion in the day of testing in the desert, where your ancestors tested and tried me and saw my works for 40 years. Because of this, I was provoked with that generation. And I said, they have always been of erring heart, and they do not know my ways. As I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter into my rest. Take care, brothers and sisters, that none of you may have an evil and unfaithful heart, so as to forsake the living God. Encourage yourselves daily, while it is still today, so that none of you may grow hardened by the deceit of sin. We have become partners of Christ, if only we hold the beginning of the reality firm until the end." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial song. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord who made us, for he is our God, and we are the people he shepherds, the flock he guides.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massah in the desert, where your fathers tempted me. They tested me, though they had seen my works. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. 40 years I was weary of that generation. I said, this people's heart goes astray. They do not know my ways. Therefore, I swore in my anger, they shall never enter my rest.
If they can hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Preached the gospel of the kingdom and cured every disease among the peoples.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your heart.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Leper came to him and kneeling down, begged him and said, "If you wish, you can make me clean." Moved with pity, he stretched out his hand, touched the leper, and said to him, "I do will it, be made clean." The leprosy left him immediately, and he was made clean. Then, warning him sternly, he dismissed him at once. Then he said to him, "See that you tell no one anything, but go show yourself to the priest and offer for your cleansing what Moses prescribed. That will be proof for them." The man went away and began to publicize the whole matter. He spread the report abroad so that it was impossible for Jesus to enter a town openly. He remained outside in the deserted place, and people kept coming to him from everywhere. Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I want to thank and welcome you to this Eucharistic celebration. And today's scripture reading, the voice of the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, reminds about the beautiful gift of conscience that God speaks to each of us in our hearts, within our hearts. God speaks within our hearts that only when we quiet ourselves that we are able to listen to the voice of God. The world in which we live is filled with so much chaos and dark elements, loud noise. As soon as you get in the car, your radio is on or your music is on. And if you roll down your window, the freeway and its sound is so much louder. And you come home, your TV is on. You want to go for a walk, your ear is filled with music. And so there's so much noise all over. Sometimes we want to hear, sometimes we don't want to hear. And we have no control over good and bad stuff that's happened outside. But we do have control over what is happening within. That's the voice of God. Only when we quietly pause ourselves, listen to him, that we will be able to hear the voice of God who speaks in sublime. Gospel, as always, so profound. The leper, it makes an initiative, because lepers are always, like an outcast. They have to stay out of the town. And he takes the initiative to come closer to Jesus and ask for help. He comes and kneels and asks for help to Jesus. Because within his heart, he knew this man can heal him. So he comes, he takes a risk, because if Jesus were not there, they would have stoned him because he broke the law. It is unclean for him to come out of their restricted zone and come to the village where people live. We which he broke, he saw Jesus. And Jesus did not threaten or did not scare him. He said, I do will it. May you be clean. It's so remarkable, sisters and brothers. I kind of thinking the whole COVID thing and the social distance that our loved ones are in the hospital, that we are not going inside. The whole thing, the risk. You know, Jesus seemed to have not been afraid of facing or meeting this person and giving him the healing. But what we are facing, kind of, but you know, health officials and everybody says, no, you can't do that, you cannot visit a person, that kind of thing. We are in the same situation. But you and I can do something within our heart for the healing of our loved ones, in prayer, united in solidarity, continue to be with him in every moment of life. Let's try our best to give the love that our loved ones need at this most difficult time. And ask the Lord for grace and strength, for he is the divine healer. We are only people who cooperate to his divine will. Please stand. Our God, we bless and thank you for this day, for the grace of mercy that you pour out upon us, your children. Bless the universal church, Pope Francis, and all people of God, that we may proclaim your love and mercy. We pray to the
Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Our God, we pray for all of us gathered here, as we all desire and love and long to be healed. We pray for the divine graces upon our humanity, upon our society, especially the suffering humanity due to COVID and all other elements. Help us, Lord, and give us the healing grace that we need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are in need of healing grace, especially we lift our hearts for Madre Lourdes and Rochelle Barstenas, that they may receive the healing grace of God, and for also for the gift of life on her birthday, Javier Rea, that the Lord may continue to bless. We ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine. We offer you the fruit of the wine, work of human hands, they will become for us the spiritual gift.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
We will accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise, glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of this holy church.
May your people's oblation, O Lord, find favor with you, we pray, that it may restore them with holiness and obtain what they devoutly entreat through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his holy, in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore, he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we are claimed. He took bread, giving you thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Myron, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Bless your children with the grace that they need at this most difficult time. Especially, we lift up Madre Lourdes, Rochelle Barstenas, and Joe Moya, and Javier Rea, who needs your divine healing through grace today. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, Saint Bernadette, our patroness, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, together we pray.
Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory be yours, now and ever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word,
and my soul shall be. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me be separated from you.
I have come that they may have life and have it more abundantly, says the Lord.
Let us pray.
Humbly we ask you, Almighty God, be graciously pleased to grant that those you renew with your sacrament may also serve with lives pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the love of Christ to be merciful like the Heavenly Father.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed day.
Thank you, Father.
Thanks be to God, whose love has gathered us this day. Thanks be to God.